in the class. Okay, today we are going to, okay, this topic only take only one class. Why? Because it's very, very easy topic and talks about the, let me look for it. Let me see it. Where is it? Oh, here it is. Here it is. It's about the new trade system that took place during those days. En aquel entonces, cuando había mucho comercio, mucho intercambio de productos entre América y Europa, como se ve, usted tiene una página, you have a picture in your books that shows this, the exchange that took place during those days. Okay, from Europe, it was taking all these crops, all these fruits and vegetables. It was sent because they didn't know about all these fruit and vegetables. It was sent to Europe. And from Europe, because we didn't know anything about all these animals and vegetables, it was sent to America. Okay, it was an exchange of products. That's why it's the new system of trade. That's the topic, a very easy topic. Now, exchanging plants, animals, and ideas. The exchange of plants, animals, ideas between the new world was America, and the old world, that is Europe, is known as the Columbian Exchange. Este proceso se le llamó the Columbian Exchange, and me imagino que el nombre de Cristóbal Colón. Columbian Exchange, okay? Now, Europeans also brought technologies such as guns, no, ellos sabían lo que era un arma, y el acero, and steel, to a new world, America. The introduction of sheep and sugar cane create new industries. Entonces ya se crearon las famosas plantaciones de sugar cane, de azúcar, las plantaciones de caña, que mucho había muchas en específicamente en el área del Caribe. En Cuba fue una potencia en lo que era la caña. Y otras, Trinidad y Tobago, todavía se produce lo que es la caña. Y eso viene de aquel entonces, que los europeos entonces comenzaron a cultivar la caña en esta área y utilizaron los esclavos africanos, ¿para qué? Para que trabajaran los cañaverales, ¿ok? Colonialists also began to grow sugar cane on plantations or large farms. Las plantaciones, se llaman las plantaciones, ¿ok? Now, Melissa, house, you're right. Okay, now plantations and mines y minas in America made money for Portugal and Spain. Porque ellos fueron los primeros que llegaron por acá, los portugueses y los españoles. Ellos se convirtieron en una gran potencia después de que consiguieron todas las riquezas que robaron, que saquearon de América. Esa es la verdad, ellos eran unos saqueadores. Okay, let me, Now, another topic talks about the mercantilism. A new economic system called mercantilism emerged. European countries saw their countries as a way to get rich. This new view of the colonies was part of an economic system called mercantilism. El mercantilismo. New trading patterns, nuevos patrones de intercambio, de negocio. Mercantilism created new trading patterns around the world. In 1600s and 1700s, trade routes connected Europe, Africa, Asia, and America. Habían cuatro rutas donde se intercambiaban productos que no se conocían. This particular trade network became known as the Triangle of Trade. Básicamente, Europa-América era el Triangle of Trade. No incluimos ni África. Ah, bueno, África sí. Asia no. Pero el triángulo era entre Europa, América y África. Now, in this picture, it shows you how it was the exchange in this triangle of trade. For instance, because they had some sugar cane plantation, they sent sugar molasses, que es la melaza de azúcar. It was sent to this area of Europe. Now, and also rum was sent to this area, a rum, because it was produced rum. Rum. Se producía rum. ¿Por qué? Porque había sugar canes. También, from Africa, it was sent a lot of people, the slaves, was sent to this area in order to work in those plantations. And also it was sent from here. This way, what over here in this area, it was like a market of slaves. Era como un mercado de esclavos. Y de aquí lo enviaban a diferentes áreas en América. Inclusive al área de acá de Norteamérica, donde había muchas plantaciones, ya sea de algodón, de otro tipo de productos. las plantaciones, las que están, siempre vemos nosotros en las películas, de las plantaciones donde los morenos, los negros trabajaban, ¿ya? So he was sent a lot of slaves in order to work in those wool plantations. Now, the Atlantic slave trade was a major part of a trade network. The Portuguese, Dutch, and English all were active in the slave trade. So, ellos eran los que se encargaban de ir a buscar a los esclavos africanos. Básicamente, los portugueses, los holandeses y los ingleses, ¿para qué? Para hacer negocios y ganar plata. Slave had been practiced in many places, including Africa, long before European kings. Ya había mucho, ya había lo que ya se practicaba eso. De esclavismo. Between the late 1500s and early 1800s, Europeans shipped millions of slaves, African to colonies in the New World. Millones, millones de africanos fueron enviados a trabajar en las plantaciones y cualquier otro tipo en América. Most of these people were sent to South America and the Caribbean. Muchos en el Caribe, por eso es que en la construcción del canal de Panamá se enviaron muchos morenos. ¿Por qué? Porque ellos tienen una gran resistencia al trabajo y al calor por su estructura ósea, los africanos. ¿Ya? Por eso que vinieron a la construcción del canal, trajeron muchas personas vinieron de allá de las islas del Caribe. Now, many ideas in this, the power shift in Europe. Power in Europe shift cambió as a result of new trade routes, banking and increased manufacturing. Aquí aparece, en esta época aparece el término banking, de bancos. Mercantilism was successful in Spain and Portugal, both of which had many wealthy colonies. But while they relied on their colonies for wealth, the northern European countries of England and Netherlands developed new trade routes and banking industries. Banking, vamos a hablar de los bancos. Increased trade created a new need for banks. People needed depositories or place to secure deposit their money. Necesitaba un sitio donde tenían que guardar su dinero y entonces aparecen los bancos. Pero ¿quién se encargaba de eso? Los que pusieron en práctica esto y tuvieron mucho éxito fueron los judíos, Jews. Realizing this, the Dutch set up a bank, prepararon un banco, los holandeses. Jews were partly responsible, los judíos eran parcialmente responsables for the growth of banking, por el crecimiento de los bancos in the Netherlands, Netherlands. Yeah. Now, the Jews were so successful that English rulers, entonces los ingleses dicen, ah, vamos a traer a ellos para que nos ayuden acá a organizar nuestra riqueza. Invited them to England to help improve business there as well. Now the new topic is about the market economy. Aquí aparece el término de economía de mercado. Okay, market economy changed business in Europe. Trade routes led to increased exchange between Europe and Africa, Asia, and America. The result of economic growth and new wealth changes business in Europe. A new social group, the middle class, began to grow. Those in the middle class had less money than rulers, por supuesto, porque son la clase media, and the upper class, en la clase alta. But more money than workers in the lower class, pero más dinero, por eso que es la clase media, entre los dos, entre la clase alta y la clase baja. Okay? There were several reasons for the increased demand for manufactured goods, productos manufacturados. Había mucha demanda. ¿Por qué? Porque, vamos a ver, la primera dice, the first, European population was growing, creció la población en Europa, especially in the cities, especialmente en las ciudades, more people meant a need for more goods. Muchas personas necesitaban tener productos porque había crecido la población, lógico, necesitaban productos. The second reason, farmers were growing food at lower costs. Producían a un costo más bajo. With lower expenses, con menos gastos, people had more money to spend on manufactured goods. And the third reason for increased demand was the addition of colonies. Habían otras colonias que también necesitaban esos productos, which had to get their manufactured goods from Europe. From Europe, okay. También las colonias acá la necesitaban. Entonces, muy bien. entrepreneurs. Entrepreneurs wanting to create new businesses to increase the supply or amount of good offer to meet the demand, las demandas, para poder que sean satisfechas las demandas de las personas que pedían esos productos. This new way of doing business can be considered the beginning of a new economic system called capitalismo. Ahí inició el capitalismo. Competition among these businesses affect how much good cost. La competencia entre estos negocios afectaba en el costo del producto. Claro, porque había demanda, voy a ofrecer menos a uno para poder que me puedan comprar el producto. Now, the new population growth of empires and cities naturally increase the size of market as well. Competition among different businesses is most successful in a market economy. As a result, businesses help meet the needs of individuals by supplying goods and services. Okay, now let's watch the video that I brought that talks about two topics. The first one talks about the triangle trade and the other one talks about the Colombian exchange that we mentioned. Let's watch it, guys.
A big concept in early American history was something called triangular trade, which of course had a little bit to do with the triangle. So you see, colonial America traded goods with Europe, which traded with West Africa, which traded with colonial America, and thus you've got the triangle. Now let's see if we can, you know, fit a little bit. There we go. So let's start with colonial America. They traded things to Europe called raw materials, which included sugar, tobacco, lumber, fish oil, and so on. Now, in return, Europe would send finished products back to America, which included furniture and cloth, guns, and so on. They would also trade these things with the West Africans in exchange for slaves, whom they would ship to the Americas, thus a triangle. Now, sometimes slaves were sent to the West Indies to work on the sugar plantations, and then the sugar would be sent up to the American colonies to make, among other things, rum. And the rum would be shipped to West Africa in exchange for more slaves. And that's another triangle. So, let's review. You've got colonial America trading with Europe, trading with West Africa, trading with the West Indies, and back and forth, and they trade across the Atlantic Ocean, and all these triangle shapes just start popping up all over the place. Thus, triangle trade.
Created using Powtoon. Okay, that was the triangle trade, and now let's watch the Colombian exchange.
For the AP US History exam or any other exam that your teacher is inflicting upon you, we've got you covered. Today, we are discussing the Colombian Exchange. So, what is the Colombian Exchange? The Colombian Exchange refers to the exchange of ideas, technologies, food, disease, and peoples that occurred between Europe and the Americas following the discovery of the New World by Christopher Columbus in 1492. When one civilization interacts with another, both cultures always experience some level of change. This is called cultural diffusion. If the differences between the two cultures are extreme, as was the case between the Europeans and the Native American civilizations during the Columbian Exchange, then the changes that follow will be equally extreme. So, in short, the Colombian Exchange resulted in a lot of change for all involved, and these changes had both positive and negative effects for the Native Americans, the cultures of sub-Saharan Africa, and Europeans. When two cultures interact for the first time, cultural diffusion is felt most by the culture with the least developed collective knowledge base, or in this case, the Native American civilizations. They experienced far greater social and economic changes than the Europeans. Animals were an important part of the Colombian Exchange. Did you know that horses didn't exist in the Americas prior to European exploration? Europeans introduced horses, pigs, sheep, goats, and chickens to the Americas. Some continued to be domesticated while others, such as wild pigs, escaped and roamed wild in the New World, often destroying agricultural crops. The Plains Indians quickly embraced the horse for domesticated use, and used them to hunt buffalo herds more easily, especially when they later acquired firearms from the Europeans. Europeans brought plants to the New World as well. These included sugar, bananas, wheat, and coffee, all of which later became major sources of American trade goods. As the slave trade increased contact between Africa and the Americas, Africans introduced rice and yams to the Americas. In return, the Europeans and Africans gained access to new crops, including corn, potatoes, cocoa, tomatoes, squash, pumpkins, and turkeys. Europeans also discovered cane sugar growing in the tropics, which had a dramatic impact upon sweetening the European diet. Interestingly, potatoes later became a main food source for many European regions, including Ireland and Eastern Europe. If you've never heard of the Irish potato famine of the 1840s, you should go check it out. The exchange of food was extremely important. Access to new foods significantly changed diets of both peoples and altered the crops that were grown in both the Old World and the New World, which ultimately contributed to a population explosion in Europe by year 1800. The Columbian Exchange is also notorious for expanding African slavery into the Americas through a new transatlantic slave trade, resulting in the forced migration of 11 million Africans over the course of 350 years. The most notorious and unintended exchange between Europeans and the Americas were the microbes. European diseases arrived with little mercy. As native immune systems were unable to defend against European disease, such as smallpox, measles, and chickenpox, these diseases spread rapidly, resulting in unintended decimation of millions. The international slave trade of Africans also introduced new diseases, such as yellow fever and strains of malaria, to the New World. Smallpox was by far the biggest culprit, as up to 95% of some Native American populations were wiped out from this single disease. It devastated Native American populations and cultures. In addition to physical goods, disease, and people, the Columbian Exchange also resulted in the widespread growth of Christianity. In what is now modern South America, Catholicism was spread through the conversion efforts of Spanish explorers and conquistadors, while North America saw the spread of Christianity through the relocation of European Protestants fleeing religious persecution. Clearly, European countries experienced more immediate benefits from the Columbian Exchange. They developed more sophisticated joint stock companies and banking institutions as a result of the newly developed transatlantic trade. Also, the need to manage colonies across oceans resulted in the development of more sophisticated political bureaucracies. The knowledge exchanged between all parties of the Columbian Exchange eventually led to more complex social, political, and economic systems for all. Some view this period as one solely of invasion, while others see it merely as a time of widespread economic and political growth. In reality, it is not one or the other, but rather a complex time period that sent the world into a new age.
Okie dokie. Okie dokie, guys. So with this video, we conclude the topic about the new trade. Yes. The new trade system, yes. Okay, guys, do we have any questions? Remember, we need to complete, you need to complete, no we, I'm not included. You need to complete the vocabulary and assessment in the side, right? All right?
Inside.
How you doing, Michelle Drape? How are you? How's everything? How's your family? How's your mom? Ana Castillo, you're sleepy. You look sleepy.
No.